For those of you familiar with hydroponic gardening, you're also familiar with the fear of flooding and the potential for thousands of dollars of property damage. I'm William Jordan and I founded Jordan Enterprises. I put a lot of thought into how to solve this problem. I wanted to find a solution that was affordable, easy to install, and provide peace of mind. To show you how this works, I have assembled a complete hydroponic system with a single growing vessel. So here it is. The Flood Stopper 2. What it does is control power to your pumps. It uses a sensor to detect high liquid levels in the growing vessel to prevent flooding. In addition, the Flood Stopper 2 comes with a low-level liquid sensor for the reservoir to prevent the pumps from running dry and burning up. Okay, let's plug the sensors in and turn the Flood Stopper on. So I'm going to go ahead and plug in the reservoir low liquid level sensor into the reservoir spot. And I'll plug the growing vessel high liquid level sensor into one of the six vessels slots. I'm going to screw them down, lock them in so they can't come loose. And then let's go ahead and plug it into that wall outlet. The pumps are already plugged into the Flood Stopper. And let's go ahead and turn the Flood Stopper on. And you'll have noticed that the pumps were already running with the Flood Stopper off. That's because the Flood Stopper only turns the pumps off if it sees a low or high liquid level situation. So now we have a hydroponic system's up and running and working normally. At this point, let's go ahead and create a partial obstruction in the drain from the growing vessel back to the reservoir and cause a flooding situation in the growing vessel. And you'll be able to see the liquid level rising now in the growing vessel. This is probably happening when you're away at work or at home asleep. There you go. The high liquid level sensor just detected too much liquid in the growing vessel, and it is turning the pumps on and off. Yeah, the pumps are turning back on when the level comes down slightly, and then it'll turn the pumps off when the level gets too high. And it'll do that from now till the end of time. Now we're going to turn the Flood Stopper off and introduce the same obstruction we did before with the Flood Stopper on, and let's see what happens. The Flood Stopper 2 is about peace of mind. It allows you to go to work, go on vacation, and go to bed without worrying about your plants dying, your pumps burning up, or thousands of dollars in property damage.